Please rise for the academic procession. The processional will be performed by the University of Nebraska at Kearney Wind Ensemble, an audition-only group of student musicians. The Wind Ensemble is directed by Dr. Dwayne Bierman, Professor of Music and Director of Bands. Dr. Bierman. Stage party is Faculty Marshal Carl Borden, Professor of Accounting, Finance, and Economics, assisted by Roger Davis, Professor of History. The stage party includes Douglas Christensen, Chancellor, University of Nebraska at Kearney. Keynote speaker Bradley Bone, UNK alumnus and assistant professor and consultant, Department of Family Medicine, Mayo Clinic. Tim Clare, Chair, University of Nebraska Board of Regents. Ted Carter, President, University of Nebraska. Jeffrey Gold, Executive Vice President and Provost. Kristen Majaka, Senior Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs. Julia Agard, Associate Professor Emeritus and Commencement Reader. Oscar Arivas, Baccalaureate Degree Candidate and Performer of the National Anthem. Mason Casper, Baccalaureate Degree Candidate and Student Speaker. Tamo Molina, UNK Student Body President and Student Regent. Paul Kenny, Past Chair, University of Nebraska Board of Regents. Kathy Wilmot, University of Nebraska Board of Regents. Mark Bauer, Director of Intercollegiate Athletics. George Holman, Associate Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs. Evan Boyd, Dean of the Library. John Watts, Vice Chancellor for Business and Finance. Kelly Bartling, Vice Chancellor for Enrollment Management. Peter Longo, Associate Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs and Professor of Political Science. Mark Reed, Dean, College of Education. Brooke Envick, Associate Dean of Faculty and Strategic Initiative and Professor of Management, College of Business and Technology. Paul Twigg, Dean, College of Arts and Sciences. Christopher Ekstrom, Professor of Chemistry and President of Faculty Senate. And Mark Ellis, Dean of Graduate Studies and Professor of History. Assisting with graduate degree candidates are Megan Adkins, Associate Dean of Graduate Studies, Reader. Janet Eckerson, Assistant Professor of Modern Languages. Kim Carlson, Department Co-Chair and Professor of Biology. Chandra Diaz-DeBose, Department Chair and Associate Professor of Teacher Education. And Michael Tihan, Department Chair and Associate Professor of Educational Administration. Reading the names of the undergraduate candidates are Julie Lands, Associate Dean and Associate Professor, Director of Online Psychology Programs. Bree Doherty, Associate Dean and Professor of Accounting, Finance, Economics. And Scott Unruh, Assistant Dean and Professor of Kinesiology and Sports Sciences. selected on the basis of achievement, activities, and scholarship to lead faculty and graduation candidates are student gonfaloniers. Grace McDonald, Honors Convocation Student Speaker and Latin Honors Gonfalonier. Jada Ruff, Graduate College. Zachary Zavodny, College of Arts and Sciences. Jack Moore, College of Business and Technology. And Claire Nelson, College of Education.
Thank you. Good morning, and please remain standing. With the marshal's placing of the university mace, we officially open the 2023 spring commencement exercises at the University of Nebraska at Kearney. Our graduates and students, members of the University of Nebraska Board of Regents, and representatives of the faculty, administration, and staff are pleased to welcome you. To begin our ceremonies, Oscar Rives Jr. of Grand Island will honor America with a solo piano performance of the national anthem. Oscar is the son of Oscar and Nancy Rives, and today he will graduate magna cum laude from the College of Arts and Sciences. He has earned a Bachelor of Music, Music Performance Comprehensive, with emphasis in piano performance, our national anthem. You may be seated. Oscar, thank you for a wonderful performance, and congratulations on your graduation with academic honors. Our best wishes to you. It is my pleasure at this time to introduce Douglas Christensen, 9th Chancellor of the University of Nebraska at Kearney. Chancellor Christensen.
Good morning. It's a privilege to welcome each and every one of you to our 2023 spring commencement exercises. Thank you for taking time out of your busy lives to come celebrate with our graduates. I know they appreciate it. We appreciate you being here so much. Graduates, what a great day. We're glad you would take the time to walk across the stage and be part of this outstanding ceremony. Oscar, great job. Outstanding. And thanks for sharing your talents. We appreciate you choosing UNK. And you're also going to graduate. That's a pretty good day in my book. You know, commencements is, it's such an exciting event, not only for the graduates, but for every person who has inspired or supported our graduates in one way or another. And today we're here to celebrate. That's what it is. It's an event to celebrate today the goals, sacrifices, challenges that each one of our graduates have overcome. They all have a different story. I wish we had time to sit and listen to them tell each one of their different stories. Some have traveled halfway around the world to study here. Others have come across the street. Some have served in our country's military. Most all of you have held a part-time, sometimes full-time job just to afford the expenses of this investment in your education. You've had sacrifices in earning your education. They're great indeed, but what you've learned and what you've achieved, they're going to pay tremendous dividends. Don't let people tell you that a four-year degree isn't worth it or a graduate degree. It really is. You've learned, you've understood different points of view, and that's important. In today's world, it's not less education, but it's more understanding. That's what we need to have. And those are the lessons that will make the world a better place, and you're going to be part of doing that. That's the reason we have such great hope in you. To the family and friends of our graduates, thank you for attending their most important day of their life. Thank you for supporting your special student. Please know that being here helps show how proud you are, just as how proud we are of the graduates. Graduates, on behalf of the faculty, the staff, and the administration of the university, thank you for choosing UNK. We really appreciate it. It's been our honor to serve you. Welcome, one and all.
Thank you, Chancellor Christensen. To bring greetings on behalf of the University of Nebraska Board of Regents, we are pleased to welcome Timothy Clare of Lincoln. He has served on the Board of Regents since 2008 and currently serves as Board Chair. Regent Clare.
Wow. This is truly a Kodak moment. And you graduates have no idea what I just said, but I promise you, your parents do. So, on behalf of my colleagues, Regents Kinney and Regent Wilmot, and our new student regent, Timo, my man, did a great job today, this morning. We'd like to extend our congratulations to the graduates today. You should all be very proud of what you've accomplished at the University of Nebraska, Kearney. Know that we are very proud of you as well. Now, aside from my parents and my brothers and a couple of coaches, Abraham Lincoln was one of my greatest heroes. And he one time said, "I prepare myself as someday my chance will come." Now, while each of you have your own unique story, each of you have worked hard, you've prepared yourself, you've earned your degree, and so now your chance has come. You're now in an excellent position to further your education, begin successful careers, improve the quality of life for you and your family, give back to communities in which you will live and work and raise your family. I commend each of you for making the wise decision to pursue higher education so that your chance will come. And I'm confident that this decision will pay off for you for the rest of your lives, no matter which direction you would choose. We hope you reflect on this day and that you appreciate it. You have achieved a major goal or milestone in your life, earning a degree. Appreciate it. Appreciate what you've had to overcome to get to this day. Things like COVID, the ups and downs of life, being away from home, being from another state or country, being a first-generation student. Whatever your situation, appreciate everything you had to overcome to get to this day. Appreciate your family and friends and loved ones who have helped you during the years. Their support and their guidance and their encouragement and their love has been and will continue to be tremendously valuable in shaping your life and helping you in your life journey. Finally, I'd suggest that you appreciate this great faculty who also have helped you on this journey. Their leadership, guidance, and education, and encouragement was beneficial to you in reaching this milestone. So again, take time today and appreciate what you've accomplished and appreciate the many people in your life that have helped you get to this day. Now, while we're on the topic of appreciation, I think you should also appreciate one another. In this fast-paced world, we don't take time to express our gratitude to one another and tell them how much we appreciate each other. You may send a text, or you may post something on Facebook or Twitter or whatever the social medium is. I've got gray hair, so Facebook's about the only one I know. But we don't take time to simply pick up the phone and call them, or better yet, tell someone to their face how much they mean to you or how much you appreciate them. So I'm going to take the privilege right now of asking all of you to stand up and turn to your neighbor and extend a hand, give them knuckles, give them a hug, whatever's appropriate, and simply say how much you appreciate each other. Okay? Everybody up, do that. Thank you. That simple expression of gratitude to your neighbor may be the only positive thing that that person hears today. Or it may simply be a statement that they needed to help pull them out of some sort of a depressed mind. Whatever the situation, I would encourage you each to maintain an attitude of gratitude, and each and every day make the investment to tell someone how much they mean to you. Remember, we rise by lifting others. The investment is free, and the dividends are endless. Now, graduates, while you cannot predict everything that lies ahead, again, I'm confident that the education you received at the University of Nebraska, Kearney, will provide you with the foundation you need to be successful. And that really is our primary focus at the University of Nebraska, helping students transform their lives through education. Some of you are about to begin your careers. Some of you may not be finished with school yet. Some of you may work for a family enterprise or start your own business someday. Some of you will raise families or travel. Some of you will come up with that innovative idea that revitalizes a community, state, nation, or even the world. These and countless other opportunities are available to you because, in the words of also University of Nebraska graduate Warren Buffett, you have invested in yourself, you've worked hard, and you've earned a college degree. So I'm confident that you'll look back and reaffirm that the University of Nebraska Kearney was the right decision for you, and that you will appreciate the decision you made to attend the University of Nebraska Kearney. You've prepared yourself. Congratulations. Your chance has come, and we wish you the best in your future endeavors. Thank you.
Regent Claire, thank you for your message and for your work on behalf of the university. University of Nebraska President Ted Carter is a graduate of the U.S. Naval Academy, a graduate of the Navy Fighter Weapons School, Top Gun, and prior to his appointment as president of the NU system in January 2020, he served as superintendent of the U.S. Naval Academy. President Carter, thank you for being with us today.
Wow, hey, good morning, everybody, yes. Thank you for the very generous and too long introduction. Chancellor Christensen, thank you for bringing us all together. Thank you for inviting me to be here. To our regents, particularly Regent Tim Clare, thank you for getting us up and exercising this morning. That will be the last of that, except for our graduates walking the stage. I'm not going to make anybody get up anymore. I love coming to Kearney. When I was the prospective president of the university, the first place I visited as I started my trek across Nebraska was to come to Kearney, Nebraska. And I'd love coming back here. And you might ask why. Maybe it's the community. Maybe it's the people. Maybe it's this campus. But truthfully, it's something bigger than all of that. It's being with each and every one of you. I love this day. I love being to see the future of not only our state of Nebraska, but our nation and our world. And for our students that are graduating today, this is your day. But before I talk a little bit more about you, I want to look over here to the faculty. This is the largest group of faculty I've seen come here. I don't know what happened today. I don't know what incentive was given for you to be here today, but you are all here today, and that is remarkable. Many of us up here noted what a large volume of our faculty and deans. Thank you for being here. But more importantly, thank you for what you've done. Thank you for the high quality education you have infused these students, the future of our state and nation. You have provided first class quality education here, and I want you to know how much I appreciate each and every one of you, and I know the class of 2023 appreciates you. For the class of 2023, this is your big day, and it's a day to celebrate, and you should celebrate. You've achieved something that not as many Americans today are doing, not only to get into college, but to complete it. And as I think about what I wanted to say to you today, there's just a couple points. First and foremost, many of you have plans, big plans. And that's good, whether you're going on to further education, medical school, going into the workforce, or just taking a little downtime for yourself before you decide what it is that you're going to do. Just know that whatever your plans are, and if you were to canvass everybody up here on the stage, they would tell you the same thing. Whatever you think will happen in the course of your life, I'm here to tell you that's not what will happen. No matter whether you're at the top of the class, the middle or the bottom, it doesn't matter. You're all graduates today. And for many of you, doors will close for those plans that you have. They happened to me. But another door will open. And one of my primary messages for you today is, don't be afraid to open that door and go through it and take the same vigor, class, and dignity that you learned here in this community, this campus, and go through that open door. Now, as I reflect on my own life, many of you know I had the privilege of wearing the cloth of our nation as a Navy officer and a naval aviator for 38 years. Yes, I actually did go to Top Gun, and I was in that teaching and learning space for my entire flying military career, flying fighter jets off aircraft carriers for most of my life. But you can't help but take that real world thing that I did and a little bit of pop culture. And sometimes art does actually imitate life. Now, I wasn't much older than some of you in here that are graduating today when I went to the original Top Gun, the Top Gun movie from 1986. I'm not going to talk about that, but the new one, whether you haven't seen it yet or seen it once or seen it 33 times like myself, has some amazing stuff in it. And I'm not going to dissect it. I'm not going to tell you what parts are real and what's not. The flying scenes are just awesome. But there's a line in the movie, and it's at a critical point in the movie, and if you weren't paying attention, you might not notice it. Tom Cruise is brought back to teach an impossible mission to new Top Gun graduates. His competitor, when he went through Top Gun 30 years prior, Tom Gazanski, Iceman, is now a four-star admiral, ailing health. He's called on his wingmen to come in and do this mission. And in that critical mission where Tom Cruise was questioning whether or not he could actually teach this, he said, "Iceman, I'm a naval aviator. It's not what I am, it's who I am." For the class of 2023, what you have gotten here at Kearney is not the end of your educational experience, not the end of that sense of curiosity to keep learning and wanting. It's that where art imitates life. And by the way, that line was actually written, not by a Hollywood producer, not by a Hollywood writer, but by a Navy fighter pilot who I actually trained. I was so proud to hear that in the movie. But relevant to today and the class of 2023, when you have that quiet moment to yourself after the celebrating's over, I ask that you think about not what you want to be, but who do you want to be? And let that define your life. And you don't have to wear the cloth of the nation. You don't have to serve in the military. You don't have to be a frontline responder. But commit to yourself that you'll serve the common good. And I'm proud of what this university system does, and particularly what we do here at UNK to help you on that path. Enjoy this day. It is your special day. And remember, you have made friends here, people sitting to your left and to your right. These are the friends for the rest of your life. These are people that helped you get through this program. And yes, you're a Loper. You will bleed blue and gold for the rest of your life, and you will always be welcome back to this community. So, for my final message today, go Lopers. Thank you.
President Carter, thank you again. Each commencement, the university community is invited to nominate students from among the graduates to deliver senior class reflections. Today's speaker is Mason Casper of Kearney. Mason is the son of Scott and Cindy Casper, and this morning he will graduate summa cum laude from the College of Arts and Sciences. He has earned a Bachelor of Science, Comprehensive Biology major with emphasis in health science. To say that Mason was involved in campus life is rather an understatement. He worked on campus as a resident assistant, a floor president, an assistant hall director, interfraternity council president, at new student enrollment, as a chancellor's student ambassador, and as a several-time office holder in his fraternity, Phi Delta Theta. He was recipient of a number of campus awards: Kearney Health Opportunities Program Scholar, Greek Man of the Year, and Resident Assistant of the Year, not to mention being named Alpha Phi Mr. King of Hearts and Mr. Crowd Favorite. Very recently, he was also honored as recipient of the prestigious Mary Jane and William R. Nestor Student Leadership Award and as an inductee in the Residence Life Hall of Fame. He studied, too. He has been on the Dean's Academic List 2019 to present, is graduating today with top academic honors, and soon he will be a student at the University of Nebraska Medical Center, aiming to one day serve rural Nebraskans as a physician. Mason has been a campus leader, a mentor, and an inspiring example to others. "I know I will always be a Loper at heart," he says, "and what more can we ask?" Please welcome Mason Casper.
Thank you all, thank you. Good morning to Chancellor Christensen, President Carter, members of the Board of Regents, our esteemed faculty, and my fellow graduates of the class of 2023. We made it. Some of us maybe didn't expect to. Some of us maybe did. Some of us are the first person in our family to earn a degree. Others maybe were the fifth or sixth. Some of us even have more school to attend after this. But no matter our situation, right now, one thing that binds us all together is that we made it. I know we've talked about gratitude a lot today, but I want to build on that more. I ask of you now to think of one person that helped get you here today. I know there are many, but please think of one person that has guided you, encouraged you, or offered you the support you needed to be here today. I challenge you to take the time today to thank them in person. If you can't thank them in person, call them. It could be a friend, a family member. It could even be Cindy from Chick-fil-A for keeping us fed on those long days of studying. But no matter who it is, tell them. It might be awkward, it might be uncomfortable, but embrace that, because gratitude is so important. As we sit here today, dressed in our caps and gowns, we reflect on the countless hours of hard work, dedication, sacrifices, and Starbucks drinks that brought us to this day. This is a day that we will cherish for the rest of our lives, and it marks the end of a significant chapter in our life. But remember that with the end of this chapter, there is a new one waiting for all of us. So make sure you relax and enjoy today. Connect with your friends and family. Talk to them and be present. This moment will be over soon, and we will all wish it would have lasted longer. It's a funny thing, the idea of a wish. It's said that birthday candles and shooting stars can bring them, or even throwing a penny down a wishing well. What an interesting tradition. The idea that by making a small sacrifice, something as insignificant as a penny, that my wishes, no matter how great, can come true. Throwing that coin into the well provides us a momentary outlet to express our deepest desires and aspirations. Sadly, though, there is no magic genie in that well. So for many, this is where their dreams will stay, stuck at the bottom of the well, just like the pennies. We can wish as much as we want for our dreams, but that alone does not accomplish anything. So I say we make our dreams come true. The true magic of a wishing well lies in the steps we take towards realizing our dreams. It is our own actions that determine whether our dreams will come true. And we have accomplished a major part of that dream today. But don't forget that this is just the beginning. Now I know that not all of our dreams are the same, but no matter your dream, remember that our journey in life is not a solitary one. In our pursuit of success, it can be easy to dismiss the value of relationships and travel alone. It's so easy to get caught up in the competitive nature of today's modern world, but it is crucial to remember that relationships with others is what fulfills us. Friends, family, coworkers, clients, even a smile and a nod as you pass a stranger on the sidewalk. It is these interactions that are the foundation upon which we build our lives, the bedrock of our happiness, and the essence of what makes us human. So cherish others, no matter who they are. The best dreams and wishes are those that are shared and attained with others in mind. If you make the people around you a priority in your dream, I promise you that 20 years from now, you will not regret it. So with that, I'm sure that many of you are wishing that I would stop talking. And like all of your other dreams, I want them to come true. So tonight, as you close your eyes, think about what's next. Sure, call it a wish, but keep your pennies. Instead, craft a plan. Visualize where you want to be, who you want to be with, and what you want to be doing in 10, 20, even 30 years. Now, don't let that image get stuck in the well. We have to go make it happen. So now, class of 2023, one last time while we're all gathered like this, I think we should throw our lopes and get one last picture as a class. Throw them, baby. Thank you.
Thank you, Mason. Congratulations on your graduation and all you have achieved these past several years. Chancellor Christensen.
Mason, thank you very much. Send me the picture, okay? Scott and Cindy Casper, I know you're over there somewhere. Thank you for sharing your children with us. We really appreciate it. The Ron and Carol Cope Cornerstone of Excellence Award was established in 2003. It's presented to individuals who have provided significant service, support, and the promotion of UNK. They also need to have supported the greater Kearney area, the state of Nebraska, and uphold the objectives of higher education. Like the Copes, who the award is named after, the recipients must be true cornerstones of the university. This is a university-wide award. All nominations are reviewed and approved by the Board of Regents. It is our highest campus honor. This morning, I'm very pleased to present this award to Carrie and Brian Hamilton. Would you please come forward? Many of you today may know Carrie and Brian or be familiar with their names through their personal and professional connections with the Kearney community. You may have bought a Jeep or a Buick or a GMC or a Chrysler at one of their Midway Auto franchises. You may have served with them on a committee or on a board or volunteer endeavor or read about them as their footprint has grown throughout the state of Nebraska. Both Carrie and Brian are native Nebraskans. They reside in Omaha. They are both graduates of the University of Nebraska, Carrie from UNO and Brian from UNL. And their roots, they run statewide. Beyond their business interests here in central Nebraska, Carrie's mother grew up in Kearney, and Oxford is where Carrie's father, Mo Beardmore, opened his first dealership. If you're graduating today, I guarantee you, they have touched your academic lives, your personal lives, and your student involvement through their personal generosity and their financial commitments to UNK and to the university as a whole. Here are some examples. They've established the UNK Brian and Carrie Hamilton Arts and Sciences Endowed Scholarship, the Brian and Carrie Hamilton Business and Technology Scholarship. They've helped renovate the football locker rooms, in fact, their name for them. In addition, through the sponsorship of their franchises, they've made tremendous contributions to athletics and other activities on campus. Things like the Loper Pantry, the UNK Chancellor's Fund, the Trustees Fund for the Future, Delta Tau Delta Fraternity, and their work as the co-chairs of UNK's Only in Nebraska Campaign Committee. That is a huge undertaking. The goal is to raise $70 million, and with them at the helm, no problem at all. They're members of the Campaign for Nebraska Committee also from 2005 to 2014. They visit our campus often, and if you see the photo in your program, if that was in color, you'd see them wearing blue and gold as they cheer on the Loper football team and all of your academic successes. Their contributions to the University of Nebraska system has been significant. Both have served on the Foundation Board of Directors and on the President's Advisory Council. And Carrie is the founding member of Women Serving in Nebraska, WIN. Their energy and willingness to serve in support of our university is admirable. This morning, it's my distinct honor to present to Carrie and Brian Hamilton the 2023 Ron and Carol Cope Cornerstone of Excellence Award. Indeed, it's friends like you who've made this campus award very special. Brian and Carrie, we are very, very proud of you. Thank you for your service to the state of Nebraska.
At this time, I am pleased to welcome Dr. Bradley Bone as today's commencement speaker. Actually, we are welcoming him back to his alma mater, where he was a Regents Scholar on the Loper football team, academic all-conference, by the way, elected as student body president and student regent, and received the UNK Outstanding Senior Award. Much like today's student speaker, he was a chancellor student ambassador, recipient of the Nestor Leadership Award. He graduated summa cum laude, and after graduation from UNK, he began study at the University of Nebraska Medical Center. Following the completion of his family medicine residency at Mayo Clinic, Brad's career path led him back to Kearney as a family physician at Kearney Clinic, an adjunct faculty for UNMC, and a provider for Kearney Hospitalists, LLC. In 2017, he returned to Mayo Clinic, where he holds the academic rank of Assistant Professor of Family Medicine and the position of Consultant in the Department of Family Medicine. Very important as well is Dr. Bone's military service. In the United States Air Force since 2007, and recently promoted to Lieutenant Colonel in the Minnesota Air National Guard, he was deployed to Afghanistan, where he served as flight surgeon for the 340th Expeditionary Air Refueling Squadron, Kandahar, and he currently serves as Deputy Chief of Aerospace Medicine. Also very important is Brad's family. He and his wife, Sarah, a UNK alum too, I'm proud to say, are the parents of three daughters, Eloise, 10, Nora, 8, Kate, 7, and son, Brooks, age 1. Brad, thank you for carving time into your very busy life to serve as today's keynote speaker. Welcome.
Before I get started today, I have to say that none of the speakers up here, to my knowledge, actually compared notes, but I think that UNK brings out a common theme, as you will see. So, members of the Board of Regents, President Carter, Chancellor Christensen, faculty, staff, distinguished alumni, parents, family members, friends, and most importantly, graduates of the class of 2023, greetings. I recall sitting in those seats 17 years ago thinking, I'm going to remember our speaker, because people always say you won't remember who talked at your graduation. Well, here I am almost two decades later, and I honestly can't remember who our speaker was. And in fact, 2006 was so long ago that when I did a Google search to find out who it was, nothing came up. However, I do remember thinking, this guy is taking forever. So, to reference one of my favorite commencement speeches by Admiral William H. McRaven, if I can't make this commencement speech memorable, I will at least try to make it short. As I pondered hours and hours thinking about what I would talk to you all about, I really wanted to embrace UNK at its heart. So, I thought about what made UNK special to me, and I cross-checked that with what's important to me, and then it came upon me, family. Let's all take a moment to thank our family. Indeed, look around the arena and feel free to wave to your beloved family members. So, now's your chance. A little bit more participation. For a very short moment, I wish to take the liberty to acknowledge my family. A special thank you to Lonnie and Marilyn Bone, my parents, for all their love and support over the years. My brother Scott and his wife Bailey and their infant Barrett. A most heartfelt thank you to my wife and fellow Loper, Sarah, UNK class of 2007 and master's in 2009, and my four children, as you heard about, who unfortunately could not be here today. Also a special thank you to Dr. Peter Longo in political science and his wife Diane, who are my father and mother-in-law, and who are about the best in-laws you could ask for. And sorry, Dr. Longo, it is too late for me to major in political science or be in the honors program. Family is at the heart of what I do on a day-to-day as a family physician. Family is what means the most in the world to me. So today I'd like to talk about family. As you have probably learned in your speech class, first I'm going to tell you what we're going to talk about. I'll talk about it, then summarize what I talked about. So here's my advice. Find your family, develop your family, and sustain your family. Before I go on, I'm going to give you my definition of family, which differs a little from the Oxford Dictionary. Oxford will say that a family is a group of one or more parents and their children living together as a unit. My definition of family is a group of people, related or not, who work together for a common cause and who love each other. Now, in my opinion, you can love people without liking them. If you love someone, you have their best interest at heart, and you respect them. In that definition, you don't have to like the same things that they like, but you all realize caring for each other and achieving your common goal are the most important aspects. So, first, find your family. I stepped onto campus in 2001, and well before the start of classes, I nervously reported to Coach Morris and the UNK football team, back when there was grass on Foster Field and before it was Cope Stadium. That was my first embrace with UNK family. I instantly had over 100 players and coaches who were in many ways my family. Just as I didn't get to choose who was on the team, you can't always choose your family. Now here's the thing about family. There are naturally people who you gravitate to within your family, and there are some people who stretch your ability to love. Please reflect on your family. Over the years, you may have found your family, like meeting for your first English 101 class. You may have been sweet mates at Centennial Towers or Nestor Hall, or met on the field while playing intramural sports. Other times, your family found you, just as was the case with my experience as an exercise science major, in athletics, fraternity life, and student government. No matter where you go or what you do, from grad school to your first job, my advice to you is to find your family and then build upon lessons gained from family. Secondly, you need to develop your family. Oxford Dictionary defines develop as to grow or cause to grow and become more mature, advanced, or elaborate. Your professors, mentors, coaches, and advisors are the ones who taught and guided you, looked out for you, and they learned from you. I guarantee those who you look up to are also looking up to you. Your teachers are learning from you every day. In my case, numerous professors nurtured and developed me. My organic chemistry professor, Dr. Kaufman, loved his students so much and was so invested in developing his family that he was visibly upset when we all did less than desired on a test. He was not upset at us for not performing. He was upset at himself for not doing a good enough job of developing us. We all learned a lot from each other that day. So, develop each other. Lastly, you need to sustain your family. Take the extra minute or two to say thank you, not only to the people whom you really like and work with daily, but get to know others who support you behind the scenes. Coach Morris made a good point to make sure that we knew the name of our custodian who cleaned our locker room every day. His name was Dave. I remember that as an important lesson because Dave really was a part of our family. So in each job that I've had, I always make an effort to get to know who is supporting me in ways that I do not even realize. Here are other ways to sustain your family. Call your parents. I mean, call your parents. Don't text, don't DM, don't post. Call your parents. They will appreciate it. Spend time with your family and friends. Tell them thank you. Thank you for the years of helping with homework, driving you to activities, worrying and staying up until you came home when you were in high school, worrying while you were here at UNK. Well, hopefully not too much because we think UNK took pretty good care of you. The gratitude you will give will mean the world to others, and that good feeling will sustain you as well. So in closing, I hope no matter where life takes you, that you find your family, develop your family, and sustain your family. This has been a special homecoming for me to return to my UNK family. Now that you all soon be alumni, we all share in the UNK family. I'm not much for selfies, but I'm going to stop for a minute to take a family photo. Go Lopes. Great families are ones that pick up right where they left off, even if it has been a long time since they have gathered. Make an effort not to make it a long time. Come back to UNK and gather with fellow Lopers whenever you can, for we are all now family. Congratulations, thank you, and go Lopers.
Thank you, Dr. Bone. Most of us think of you as Brad, but either way, it's a pleasure to welcome you back. I believe your parents, Marilyn and Lonnie Bone, and your brother Scott and wife Bailey are here this morning, and I would like to recognize them too. Marilyn and Lonnie, Scott and Bailey, would you please stand? And now we have arrived at that special moment, the conferring of degrees. We will begin with the awarding of the graduate degrees. Candidates for the graduate degrees will be presented by Dr. Mark Ellis, Dean of Graduate Studies.
Brad, thanks for that important message. We're very lucky to have you as part of the Loper family. Will the candidates for the graduate degrees please rise? Dr. Majoka, these applicants have completed all the requirements established by the Board of Regents for the respective graduate degrees. The UNK graduate faculty, therefore, recommends that they be granted the graduate degree along with the privileges and the responsibilities that accompany their degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the University of Nebraska and on the recommendation of the faculty of the University of Nebraska at Kearney, I hereby confer upon each of you the appropriate graduate degree and admit you to all of its rights, honors, privileges, and obligations. Congratulations.
Graduate degree candidates, you may be seated. Dr. Megan Adkins, Associate Dean of Graduate Studies and Academic Innovation, will read the candidates' names. Hooding the candidates for the graduate degrees are Dr. Janet Eckerson, Assistant Professor of Modern Languages. Dr. Kim Carlson, Professor of Biology. Dr. Chandra Diaz-DeBose, Associate Professor of Teacher Education. And Dr. Michael Tihan, Department Chair, an Associate Professor of Educational Administration.
Good morning. Today we'd like to recognize the following UNK graduates. Josie Blessen. Brianna Elise Brock. Trisha Lenhart. Rylan Victoria Ann Mahoney. Heidi Tihan. Ashley Ann Marie Wagner. Nathan B. Weaver. Melissa Jean Berry. Olivia G. Slater. Jada M. Ruff. Krista Sue Albert. Berna Dean Anderson III. Sarah K. Armin. Angela Christine Bardell. Brandon Neil Baxter. Aldo Briones. That's a cheering section. Maria Marlin Burgos. Chelsea Ray Christensen. Cammie Christman. Charles Nicholas Corcoran. Katie Jo Coy. Kristen E. Douglas. Madeline R. Eldridge. Margaret L. Florell. Sammy Fox. Trey Douglas Fry. Deanna Goranson. Rachel Alicia Harper. Tiffany Lynn Hines. Crystal Nicole Jepson. Catherine May Covanda. Sophia Grace Cradleville. Jared Michael Lechner. Brenda Lopez Adam. Alex Lufer. Trisha K. Martinson. Jeffrey Scott Matthews. Amy McBain. Becca Christine Olson. Alan Wade Osborne. Taylor Elaine Peters. Molly Kathleen Rieger. Jenna Ray Robinson. Congrats. Donald Roeder. Joshua James Rowan. Taylor Shaler. Schlecht. Hillary K. Schlecht. Josiah Tear Scholard. Samantha K. Snowgren. Ashley Lynn Stone. Thomas Allen Tews. Justin Dinyan Chang. Stephanie Jimenez Limos. Mikhail Ranta. Blaze Steven Rakusek. Tyler Shaner. Mila Monique Bednar. Amber Bendig. Gina Lee Blackman. Adam Keith Brock. Laura J. Kitka. Bailey J.L. Duvall. Melissa Donahue. Maddie Lynn Drews. Allison Pauline Gansmer. Paige Renee Guzman Core. Stacy Helt. Melody Dawn Howard. Megan Nicole Jacob. Austin M. Jacobson. Chanel L. Johnson. Cassidy Kirsch. Catherine Elizabeth Klein. Kayleen Coma. Jennifer Lauder. Sarah Jean Lewis. Connor Max. Rachel Nicole Max. Megan A. McFadden. Ellen Marie Meyer. Andrian Olson. Catherine Piper. Amy Suzanne Picorni. Tessa Christine Ruskamp. Jody Renee Selgrove. Brianna Dale Simons. Gabrielle Renee Stroop. Rose Marie Sullivan. Allegra Mary Woolen. Haley Lee Ariki. Laren Delaney Fear. Regina Forbes. Heather Marie Harrison. Andrea O'Brien. Grace Aoife O'Neill. Patricia Keelan Schmidt. Dakota Schroeder.
These are our graduates. Please join me with a blue and gold loper. Congratulations.
At this time, we will confer the undergraduate degrees. Peter Longo, Associate Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs and Professor of Political Science, will present the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees.
Will the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees please rise? Vice Chancellor Majaka, I am happy to present you the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees in their specialized areas. They have completed all the requirements for their degrees as prescribed by the University of Nebraska at Kearney and the Board of Regents. It is the recommendation of the faculty that they be granted their degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the University of Nebraska and on the recommendation of the faculty, I hereby confer upon each of you the baccalaureate degree and admit you to the Fellowship of Educated Men and Women with all of its rights, honors, privileges, and obligations. Congratulations.
Graduates, you may be seated. The baccalaureate degrees will be presented by Paul Twigg, Interim Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, Brooke Envick, Associate Dean of the Faculty in Strategic Initiatives and Professor of Management, College of Business and Technology, Mark Reed, Dean of the College of Education. Reading the names of the graduates will be Julie Lands, Associate Dean and Associate Professor of Psychology and Director of Online Psychology Programs, College of Arts and Sciences. Bree Doherty, Associate Dean and Professor of Accounting, Finance, Economics, College of Business and Technology. And Scott Unruh, Assistant Dean and Professor of Kinesiology and Sports Sciences, College of Education. We will begin with the College of Arts and Sciences. Dean Twigg.
The College of Arts and Sciences is proud to announce the following graduates. Zachary Zavodny. Grace Elizabeth McDonald. Kylie Jean Anderson. Georgina A. Artiga Rodriguez. Mallory Doreen Bruning. Jonathan Thomas Drozda. Jaden Brianne D. Zingle. Erlen Gutierrez. Lucy Lynn Harmon. Shelby Taylor Haney. T. Huynh. Stephen Lee Kane. James Leonard Creesh. Yvonne B. Lopez. Kayla Marie Lopez. Charlotte Rose Okraska. Elizabeth Ann Pease. Oscar Alejandro Arrivas, Jr. Caitlin A. Flaster. Jennifer Sanchez. Emma Elise Seward. Ashby Dawn Stevens. Jose Luis Arredondo. Curtis R. Bailey. Sarah Elizabeth Ferador. Sadie May Fidelke. Dylan J. Fisher. Gabrielle Elizabeth Gayden. Kaylee Marie Kathman. Madison Koburnick. Thank you. Bailey Marie Kopish. Brittany Nicole Kuma. Cassie Marie Lechman. Hannah Victoria Lanuski. Kirsten K. Lubke. Isaac Vincent McPhillips. Emma Teresa Miller. Abigail Jean Parlin. Preston K. Peterson. Andrew Douglas Pierce. Marcella R. Sutton. Macy Michelle Welch. Daria Elena Wilson. Benjamin James Ahrens. Marissa Elizabeth Baker. Maximilian Jacob Baker. Michaela Marie Bartels. Mason Allen Casper. Roxy Michelle Baumgartner. Cecilia Danielle Beam. Mallory A. Beckman. Lauren Elise Bank. Joshua Bulkey. Stacy Leanne Bott. Brianna Nicole Bro. Sydney Danae Briney. Kevin Lyle Bird. Tanner G. Butler. Christian David Candelaria Eubanks. Wynn Noel Cannon. Brooke Brianna Carlson. Olivia Ann Casper. Lucia K. Castro Jacobo. Madison R. Cervera. Madison Lee Cherick. Haley Amber Clark. Chase Christian Clausen. Tristan John Colford. Emma Claire Collins. Alexandra Lee Danson. Allison Joe Darrow. JC Ray Dietz. Amber Dawn D. Zingle. Hope Lynn Edmonds. Teresa L. Emmons. Nicole Marie Erpelding. Nathan Dean Fancher. Anthony J. Faz. Tate Eugene Furno. Anna Christina Flores Cardenas. Madison Rose Ford. Thomas Fox. Alexandria Josephine Frasher. Meredith Genevieve Geyer. Grant Ryan Gannon. Fabiola M. Gonzalez Alvarado. Dylan J. Graff. Logan Henry Gross. Nayeli Guido Vargas. Jacob Martin Gutenschritter. Madison May Hollowell. Michaela Margaret Harbles. Eka Hasetu. Sophie Sue Hassenstab.
Yes, Sophie Sue!
Flora Hay. Ashley Marie Hine. Cora Jade Hemmer. Caleb Leroy Hendrickson. Joseph Christopher Hyatt. Macy Renee Hill. Justin Ibarra. Teresa Michelle Jeffries. Cassidy Johnson. Ian Riley Johnson. Tina Angelina Cadoville. Jennifer Melissa Kelly. Alexander Thomas Kemp. Megan King. Olivia Claire Koenig. Hannah Lee Coomer. Brenna Naomi Larson. Madeline Nicole Laquana. Carolee Rose Legg. Vanessa Lynn Lowe. Nathan James Lowther. Satori Ann Lutz. Christina Ann Markgraf. Samantha Elizabeth Martinez. Coral M. McClintock. McClintock. Luis Antonio Mejia Jr. Stephanie Summer Grace Meyer. Michelle Lized Morales Garcia. Hannah Rose Moravec. Bonita Marie Naughton. Elizabeth Opal Newkirk. Bailey Ann Oberhauser. Chloe May Obermeyer. Aiden Taylor Ureta. Samantha Lee Pella. Zachary Daniel Pettit. Molly Suzanne Platt. Charles Xavier Polin. Hannah Nicole Pollen. Jacob Benjamin Putnam. Adamari Ramos Loeza. Cannon Scott Rath. Devin Redman. Nora Faith Rennard. Peyton Christine Rain. Ninewar Reek. Rosalia Rikenis Castro. Ashley Camille Romich. Emily Jamila Saudi. Samuel Blaine Shent. Elizabeth B. Shipley. Jeremiah Franklin Sugar. Adeline Elaine Sides. Reagan Cole Sykes. Jill Nicole Smith. Justin Matthew Spencer. Robin Renee Springer. Ashley Nicole Stanton. Audrey Ann Stelling. Martin Riley Strachan. Lucas Dean Stuckey. Nafisa Tahiru. Trenton James Tice. Grant Douglas Ty. Noah V. Tillman. Amy Laurie Trice. Caitlin R. Vandewall. Chase Edward Villers. Jason Jordan Walton. Mariah Diane Watson. Andrew Blake Welch. Kristen Eve Watovic. Caitlin Elizabeth Whitcomb Allen. Kelsey Marie Woodard.
Allison Caitlin Yarborough. Ellie Zimniak. Nathaniel Isaac Fields. Annalisa Jolling Heckel. Hannah Marie Crabel. Timothy David Sykes. Ariana Mystique Warner. Grace Catherine Dvorak. Sophia Elizabeth Gilsdorf. Kayla Nicole Milliken. Stephanie Vielmas Duarte. Allison Janae Moss. Emily Claire Palmer. Clarissa Therese Paltz. Sophia Mamie Schroeder. Jordan Marie Shoemaker. Cassidy Corinne Stelling. Okay. Mariah Danielle Johnson. Abigail L. Nemec. Jesse M. Atchison. Rebecca Ann Bristol. Xavier Javon Delk. Lexi Elizabeth Hayek. Allison Nicole Jen. Sarah Rydell Lawless. Ryan Christopher Parkos. Sonia Karina Robles.
Wouldn't think so. It didn't seem to be a switch.
No. Oh, it is? Is there
test? Okay. The College of Business and Technology is proud to announce the following graduates once they get up here. Jack Moore.
Carson James Schwarz. Seth Velasic. Sarah Ann Arbuck. Cora June Asp. Thomas Michael Bellew. Babario De Jesus Bernal Williamson. Lane Bertrand. Michaela Rose Bookley. Stephanie Nicole Casera. Henry Romero Chaken Ibarra. JC Clary. Connor Conrad. Shaming Ding. Mary Ruth Dodes. Joaquin Dominguez Camancha. Garrett Stephen Engel. Jaden Daniel Ingen. Brooke Renee Farr. Ashley Fire Robin. Bailey Elizabeth Flynn. Christopher Gomez. Jose Manuel Jr. Gonzalez. Autumn Graham. Miguel Angel Guerrero. Austin Hansen. Avery Marie Pullman Haskin. Catherine Elizabeth Hines. Carter James Henry. Dane Matthew Heinrichs. Jack Hinziker. Carson Hirata. Anamika Jha. Caitlin Elizabeth Camper. Carter Kyle. Cassidy Joe Kennedy. Connor Michael Clausen. Jonathan Robert Kement. Cody Canahans. Judd Kuchera. Daniel Kitkuski. Jackson Paul Lane. Caden Lefebvre. Trevor Linden. Amanda Lobig. Irma Lulaj. Jameson Leisinger. Ryan McDonald. Haley Elizabeth Maltzberry. Trevor Leroy Matusik. Michaela Renee McFate. Hector Melendez. Colton Messman. Emily Miksch. Delaney McRoshick. Taylor Jordan Muse. Garrett Don Neal. Maria Nupol. Cade Matthew Nicole. Peyton Lee Oliveris. Joshua Martin Lynn Olson. Ashley Rose Parker. Jaden Michael Paul. Joel Clifton Pullen. Kenneth Hayden Prince. Cooper James Reese. Kiera Tukruka Rhodes. Brendan Michael Roberts. Regina Robles Marquez. Paola Romero. Caden Ray Rungi. Lane Peyton Sabell. Jackson Keith Sani. Garrett Savick. Janie Shalance. Brian Whalen Schneider. Hannah Elizabeth Schuster. Landon Burke Seibert. Logan Tex Shaw. Narajan Shurtha. Jordan Nicole Smets. Reagan Isabel Stabenow. Brett James Steinke. Cornelius John Stratman. Jack Thomas Sutton. Nathan Austin Savek. Sydney Morgan Thurlow. Derek Lee Tolls. Macy A. Turk. Jalen Isaac Turner. Emma Nicole Wojciechowski. Tatum Jean Vondra. Justin Lee Viroman. William Thunder Brave Bear White. Brooke Taylor Williams. Tyler James Wirtz. Caitlin Michelle Yeager. Cole Lawson Young. Andrew Arlen Zaruba. Carson John Zwingman.
The College of Education is proud to honor its graduates and remind the audience that it is the college home of our speaker, Brad Bone, Kinesiology and Sports Sciences. I just thought I'd throw that out there. If you'd please come. Gentry N. Barner. Brooke Noel Bank. Rebecca Jo Bentz. Catherine Ann Boyce. Skylar A. Capel. Maxwell G. Chatelain. Sarah Elise Collins. Molly Ann Combs. Horacio Corona. Bianca Elizabeth Diaz. Ariana Lynn Estelmeyer. Jenna Marie Evans. Brianna Lee Ionik. Megan Lee Fisher. Bailey Jean Fortune. Claire Elise Nelson. Lauren Catherine Grechik. Heath Gregory Haberman. Taryn Elise Hadwiger. Katie Lucille Harmon. Jordan Christina Harry. Jaslyn F. Haroon. Amanda Renee Horanek.
I'm gonna get it right.
Justine Elizabeth Johnson. Courtney K. Kinney. Arielle Taylor Kimenaw. Jessica Jill Klingelhofer. Brittany Lynn Kruger. Lucy Alianise Langstraight. Adelaide Ann Maxwell. Madison Mazur. Matthew Eldon McFarlane. Kylie June McManigal. Carmen Jane McPhillips. Bree Morgan Meyer. Kylie Faith Miller. Jennifer Naba. Addison Joe Audi. Tristan Shea Oxford. Courtney Alexandria Petzold. Shelby Laren Pocock. Jocelyn Jane Rauert. Carolyn Ann Reed. Sarah Iveth Romero. Jenna Marie Rover. Hayden Ray Reinerson. Lindsay Renee Sawyers. Laurel Marie Schmidt. Jordan S. Scott. Isabel Short. Megan Lynn Slocum. Elizabeth Marie Snell. Emma Catherine Stoliker. Caroline Jean Stanley. Keidra Jared Taylor. Dre Taylor. Destiny Leanne Toole. Kayla Ann Wagner. Aubrey Waldemar. Hannah Lynn Walker. Cassidy Paige Weiss. Haley Mae Whitty. Dominic Antoine Addison. Taylor Ann Becker. Reed Douglas Bilby.
Get this right.
Brittany Janae Brocious. Anna Lynn Birkink. Janae Christian Collins. Johnny Christian Collins, sorry. Johnny. Tyrone Davis Jr. Parker Lloyd Erkey. Derek William Elton. Juan M. Espinoza Jr. Trevor A. Colder. Nathan Dell Gustafson.
I get this one right.
Hannah Elizabeth Hardy. Elisa Ray Holbrook. Michaela Jean Johnson. Kennedy Joe Jones. Chloe Jean Kolb. Kaylee Ann Coomer.
Got it right.
Nicholas L. Landinger. Tatum Lee Lang. Tristan Leanne Larson. Paige Christine Lacero. Aspen Elizabeth Libby. Sebastiana S. Mateo Domingo. Cassandra McDonald. Eden Keiko Miura. Did I get it? I think I got it. Jaden Lee Morse. Lucas Joseph Polacek. Haley Hirschfeld Pohl. Emma Marie Rydell. Isaac William Robertson. Sierra Christine Rose. Tanner Colton Rudu. Ruda, excuse me. Arceli Nichelle Salazar. Jacob Matthew Schleicher. Grace Lynn Sauerdyke. Michael Dean Still. Claire Elizabeth Vanderbeek. Elise Marie Volk. Carson Eugene Walker. Kyler Michelle Watts. Isabella C. Whiston. Macy Marie Weidick. Connor Allen Wiggins. Sierra Joe Willenberg. Hayden Suzanne Baldwin. Nayeli Isabel Cruz. Sophie Lee Eberly. Elizabeth Gensel. Sabrina Marie Hamling. Jarrett William Havens. Dawson Allen Helmer. Carson Eric Clues. Paige Elizabeth Moore. Jared Andrew Owen. Stephanie C. Padilla Exibo. Kareem Yarnett Perez Diaz. Jamie Lynn Pierce. Janaea Lynn Pierce. Sarah Jan Rip. Vanessa Rodriguez. Logan J. Schroeder. Fallon Deneen Stutheit. Rebecca Gail Sweeney. Catherine Arthur, Carrie Arthur Trogdon. He tore it up. I can hardly read it. Carrie Arthur Trogdon. Lauren Mary Waskowiak. Sarah Melissa Waugh. Megan Lynn Whelan. Jaleesa Reagan Nicole Wilkerson.
These are our baccalaureate graduates. Will you all please join me in extending our hearty congratulations to them?
Congratulations, graduates. At this time, I ask that everyone in the audience or on the stage who is a UNK or Kearney State College graduate to please stand and remain standing for today's turning of the tassel ceremony. Please stand. Today's graduates, would you please also stand? The turning of the tassel after graduates have received their diplomas is a time-honored tradition, symbolizing the transition from candidate to graduate. It is a privilege well earned. Alumni, faculty, families, and guests, please give a warm welcome to the newest members of our alumni community, the graduating class of 2023. Graduates, now is the time to turn your tassels. My congratulations to each of you. Everyone may be seated. To further welcome our newest UNK alumni, I am pleased to introduce Hilke Brandon Meyer. Hilke received her Bachelor of Science from UNK in 2012 and her Master of Business Administration also from UNK in 2019. Now a private banker at American National Bank in Omaha, she also serves her alma mater as president of the UNK Alumni Association Lead Council. Hilke.
Thank you, Senior Vice Chancellor. I realize I'm the only thing standing between you and celebrating, so I'll make sure to keep this brief. UNK Class of 2023, congratulations on such a tremendous achievement. On behalf of over 56,000 fellow UNK graduates, it is my honor and privilege to officially welcome you into the Alumni Association. It has never been a more exciting time to be a LOPER. With the Only in Nebraska campaign launching last fall to address the future needs of the university and state, and the Hamiltons graciously serving as our committee chairs, pride for UNK is at an all-time high. I encourage you to piggyback off this momentum and fully utilize our Loper network as you start the next phase of your lives. Join us at an upcoming alumni event in your area or reach out to a new connection in your industry on the range. Many of our alumni have invaluable experience, connections, and wisdom in their respective fields, and I promise you that they would be thrilled to share that with you. Likewise, it is never too early to start making your own impact on the Alumni Association. Share your Only in Nebraska story with prospective students. Promote and attend our events with your friends, or offer your time and talents and serve as a volunteer. Don't wait. Before you know it, you'll be a decade out of college. 10 years ago, I was standing in this exact spot giving the student commencement address. Mason, your speech blew mine out of the water. Well done. I was about to start my dream job working for the St. Louis Cardinals, so at the time, I made a lot of baseball references, listing Chancellor Christensen as the general manager, our faculty and staff as coaches, and of course, our friends and family as the fans. Looking back, I realized I failed to mention one significant university group, you guessed it, our alumni base. The Spirit Squad or Tailgate Crew, whichever you prefer, your Loper family, ready to welcome, support, and cheer you on as your new grads in joining the Workforce and Alumni Association. You will encounter these loud and proud Lopers throughout your life. Often, when you least expect them, you could really use the encouragement. Know that we appreciate the difference you made at UNK, leaving the place that we all call home better than you found it. But we are even more excited to witness your future success and legacy you are destined to leave in the world as a Loper. Congratulations again, class of 2023. Your Loper family is rooting for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Hilke. We are grateful for the opportunity to have served as both an undergraduate and graduate student, and we appreciate your work very much on behalf of the Alumni Association and the UNK community. Thank you for being with us today. At this time, would everyone please join me in recognizing our distinguished faculty. Faculty and emeriti faculty, please stand and accept our appreciation. Thank you also to UNK's staff. As always, we could not have done this without you. You have helped make these graduation exercises a wonderful occasion. Graduates, congratulations, you made it. Enjoy today. Tomorrow starts your next chapter of learning. Dive in enthusiastically with the knowledge that you are well prepared for a promising future that awaits you. Parents, families, friends, and guests, thank you for sharing this day with us. Thank you for sharing these achievements and this celebration. Best wishes always. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Majaka. Audience, as we come to the conclusion of today's ceremony, please remain seated until the recessional has been completed. University Marshal Borden, Dr. Davis, and student Gonfaloniers, please prepare for the recessional. Will the stage party please stand? Dr. Bierman, Drs. Borden and Davis, and Gonfaloniers, you may begin the recessional.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.